Welcome to the new section of Gospel Reading and Reflection. Today, October 23rd, 2020. I am Father Stephen John. If you did not subscribe to this channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon to receive the Gospel Reflections regularly. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke chapter 12 verses 54 to 59. Jesus said to the multitudes, "When you see a cloud rising in the west, you say at once, 'A shower is coming.' And so it happens. And when you see the south wind blowing, you say, 'There will be scorching heat,' and it happens. You hypocrites, you know how to interpret the appearance of earth and sky. But why do you not know how to interpret the present time? And why do you not judge for yourselves what is right? As you go with your accuser before the magistrate, make an effort to settle with him on the way, lest he drag you to the judge, and the judge hand you over to the officer, and the officer put you in prison. I tell you, you will never get out till you have paid the very last copper." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear brothers and sisters, in the book of Prophet Jonah, we read, he was reluctant to go to Nineveh since it was a Gentile nation, and he tried to run away to avoid going to Nineveh. But God, out of his mercy, compelled Jonah to go to Nineveh, and he preached repentance in Nineveh, and they listened to prophet and repented. So God withdrew his punishment from them. When we come to the New Testament, both John the Baptist and Jesus preached the coming of the kingdom of God, but the Pharisees and many Jews did not heed their voice. However, many sinners and those excluded from the society listened to them and received the good news happily. In this chapter, chapter 12 of Luke's Gospel, we see the Pharisees, because of their hypocrisy, do not accept Jesus. The crowds, because of their hypocrisy, refuse to see God's pivotal moment of salvation history present in Jesus' kingdom ministry. The people are very much known to predict the weather by looking at the sky, but they do not understand the coming of the kingdom by the works Jesus did among them. Pharisees complained the work he did by the power of Beelzebub, and some asked for the signs from heaven to believe. Ironically, the crowds have sufficient intelligence to know the signs in the sky, but they fail to understand the signs of the kingdom of heaven. With his next illustration, Jesus challenges the crowd to make an effort to settle with the accuser on the way. If you succeed in reaching an out-of-court settlement, Jesus suggests you avoid the risk that the divine judge will render a judgment against you. Responding to the accuser with anger only increases hostility. But goodwill and desire to be reconciled helps restore friendship. After speaking about the importance of vigilance and the awaiting judgment, Jesus tells the crowd to be ready to negotiate with him to avoid divine punishment. The divine Lord, who loves everyone and wants the people to reconcile with him to prevent the punishment, awaits them. Their external observance of the law will not give them salvation unless they open their hearts to Jesus and love him. In a talk given in the Netherlands in 1985, Pope John Paul II put it in this way: "External observance of the law has no great value if the heart is blind or wicked. The heart, in other words, the conscience, must be purified and informed. Christ reveals to his disciples that here is a value that surpasses all others and binds them together. Love. This law of love, which contains the law and the prophets, must become the law of their conscience." Let us pray. Heavenly Father, through the work of the Holy Spirit, give me the ability to understand the signs of the time. Help me to listen to the word of God and practice it in day-to-day life. I ask for the desire and courage to seek reconciliation always with your Son. Melt my pride and help me to delay no longer. I pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen.